Let's get to trouble for the Libs this morning, Susan. The New South Wales state branch, it's all at sea. Can a federal takeover save it?
It's a 10-month intervention, Pete. Others have described it differently, but as part of those discussions under Peter's excellent leadership on this, what we are doing is making sure that our New South Wales division is in the best fighting form that it needs to be, match fit for the next election. I think it was Paul Keating who said, where goes New South Wales, there goes Canberra. So this is something that the federal division has written to the New South Wales division. They've got until next Thursday to respond to the proposal. And our sole focus, my sole focus, Peter's focus is to make sure that we win seats. We've got outstanding candidates already on the ground in New South Wales, and we know that we have to move seats in order to change the government next time
round. Yeah, I mean, you've got a federal election, though, that's...
We're doing this, and for millions of Australians.
Yeah, you've got a federal election that's less than 10 months away, so are you concerned at all about implications leading into that election?
I'm focused on one thing, and that is that we win seats in New South Wales,
but
we win seats around the country.
Not worried
and
about
we want the New South Wales. We want the New South Wales division. We want the New South Wales division to be in the best possible position to do exactly that, to fight this campaign hard. And yesterday's conversations, which have been constructive, and as I said, a letter has been written to New South Wales. They'll respond by next Thursday. This is about cooperation. It's about a constructive relationship, and it's about supporting the millions of Liberal Party members in our state and across the country who want to see us do well.
Okay. I've got to get this one in. Just a quick one to close on. There's a piece in the Nine newspapers this morning that says the Prime Minister made a captain's call over a census question on gender status because he didn't want it to be a thing. It became a thing and he made a captain's call of a captain's call by reversing it. And it was then leaked. Your thoughts on trouble behind the scenes there?
Three members of the Prime Minister's Cabinet independently calling journalists. This is quite extraordinary. This is a leak on a massive scale. These ministers, of course, are picking up the phone to journalists instead of doing their day job, which is to actually manage their portfolios in the interests of all Australians. But yes, it does show that things are not happy behind the scenes with the Prime Minister's Cabinet. But I just want these ministers to focus on what they're supposed to be doing, not backgrounding journalists about what happens behind closed doors in what is supposed to be a confidential cabinet.
Okay.
So it doesn't make the Prime Minister look good at all.
Okay. Have you ever leaked, Susan Ley?
No.
No? Okay. Just checking. Talk to you soon.
No, and Cabinet is a really important forum.
Okay.
And for three ministers to leak, it seems independently, I think it's quite extraordinary. That, to me, says a lot, Pete.
All right. If you have 3 minutes today, Susan Ley, check out Informer by Snow. You'll know what I'm talking about. Anyway, I'm stopping
it's
there.
You see, Pete, my era was the punk rock of the 1980s.
Okay.
So
right.
I'll have
Good
to move
to
forward.
We'll talk
90s.
To you soon.